Doing it for Victory MMA. Let's hear it for Kyle Herrera. Pounds fighting for the pro lightweight title tonight. He is a striker style fighter. Where is he training out of?
Training out of Victory MMA over there with Jake Paul. His day job.
That's Jake Paul right there. Good looking man off to the right.
Jake Paul. Juvenile Observation and Assessment Guidance Counselor.
Yes.
So he works with troubled youth.
Yeah, he was actually working with, I want to say, Unified Police Department or one of the local police departments for a short period of time. And then stop doing that. He's working over there. I think he's been with the juvenile observation for a little while.
Uh-huh.
But he is over at, like we said, Victory MMA. He's actually one of the head coaches at Victory MMA.
You mentioned that earlier on the broadcast.
He's got, I mean, all of Victory is back there with him.
That's what I was doing. I was looking at a huge number of people behind me.
Ryan
Wilkinson. Always there. Yes. Always supporting.
So Jake Paul is his coach, his main corner right now tonight. Uh-huh. I have an obligation to say that he is the best looking corner in MMA today. And then you can see you got Brenda Enriquez behind, right behind him. You know, she just turned pro. She just actually won a big fight for, I want to say Combat Americas.
Yes, yes.
And, which is a all Latino, Latina MMA promotion.
Rather new, rather big.
Yes. It's another big one. You've got Clay, you've got, you've got all the guys back there. So
we can just keep going if you want.
You know, Kyle's a great guy. He's really fit. He's always putting in the work. He wants to say, as far as family, he wants to thank his dad for pushing him at a young age to get into martial arts. And as far as how he got started, his dad enrolled him in Shintoshi Karate when he was six. After 7 years, he moved into boxing at a boxing gym for a couple of years. A few years later, in 2008, his buddy from high school, Jake Paul, best-looking corner in MMA today, drug him along to one of his MMA classes, and he's been hooked ever since. What does he say it means to fight for Steel Fist?
He says fighting for Steel Fist is a privilege. They work very hard to put on an event every 6 weeks, back to 16 fights per card. They work to make their fighters happy and eager to come back.
That's right. His message for his opponent, Thiago Alves, will be a great test for me. Unfortunately for him, this has been one of his best fight camps, and I refuse to leave without the belt around my waist.
And his opponent tonight, fighting out of the black corner, standing 5'8" tall, weighing in at 154.2 pounds, with a record of 7-4. Doing it for Team Link, let's hear it for Thiago Alves!
Now you can tell that there are a lot of Kyle Herrera with all the booze in the background. But you know what? Don't let the booze fool you. This guy is legit.
Thiago is legit. As you can see, he's back there. He's preparing.
Waiting for the beat to drop.
Yeah, I mean, Thiago's a very cerebral fighter at the same time.
Yes.
You know, if you saw him outside of the cage, you would have no clue that he was an MMA fighter. Honestly, he comes across more as a nerd.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I mean, we just saw him cutting weight the other night. Me and my son, he started walking away. My son's, yeah, he really does kind of look nerdy.
Man, after my own heart. Wonder if he cosplays. Anyway.
Maybe. So,
just kidding. So, I think he found that spot. He's coming out right now.
There he is.
Black belt around his neck, ready to do this. What do we know about this guy?
Well, I know he's got some fire in him tonight. But aside from the fire, he weighed in 155 pounds. He's 34 years old. Has a record of 10-5. His fighting style is jiu-jitsu, of course. We know he's over there at Team Link. You know, Fabio Serrao is his head coach.
Well, you see Fabio Serrao right there holding his belt, taking his pants. That's his corner tonight, too.
Yes.
Another amazing and legitimate black belt.
Eric Iman, another large-bodied man. You can only see maybe his beard in our picture.
Part of his torso.
Yes, he would be the striking coach over there at Team Link. Now, again, I have quite a relationship with Thiago when he came up from Brazil. You know, seeing him fight different weights, 55, 45. You know, he is a true soldier. I do know he's fired up for this fight. Something happened to Wayans last
night. Yeah, there was
night.
A little bit of back and forth in the commentary between
yeah.
the two guys last night.
Which is different from Thiago.
Yeah, there's some good pictures
Thiago
on the Still Fist
down.
Fight Night Facebook page. You can go check it out. There's some good pictures of the Wayans. A lot of finger pointing and yelling.
Well, and I saw on Thiago's post was he was very disrespectful to me tonight. He will pay for it tomorrow.
Oh, wow. So we know his day job. He is a jiu-jitsu
coach.
That's what he does.
For his living.
Family and friends, he says he'd like to thank everyone, and he wants to thank all of his family and friends for their support. And then as far as what it means to fight for Still Fist, he says fighting for Still Fist Fight Night title is very good to showcase my skills. Now remember, he's Brazilian.
Yeah.
So his English, you know, the way it comes across.
When he first came up, he had no English.
Yeah.
Since he's been coming up here, he used to fight down in Brazil a lot, but they don't pay you much. They were paying him in toasters.
Toasters?
Yes, seriously, toasters. You know, he has stories of him, you know, fighting, going to the
All
hospital.
All right, gang, this is your main event for the professional lightweight title. One more time, out of the red corner, Kyle Herrera. And his opponent, out of the black corner, Thiago Alves!
Alright, guys. This will be my command at all times. Protect yourself at all times. Once you do not protect others, yourself, the fight will end. You understand?
Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we're about to get this main event started. This is for the professional lightweight championship for Still Fist Fight Night. If you're just tuning in, Kyle Herrera in the red corner with the red Venom trunks. Thiago Alves out of the black corner with the white and red trunks, Team Link trunks. All right. Ryan, what do you think?
Honestly, to me, this is a very interesting fight. You know, Thiago comes in, has a great jiu-jitsu background that we all know about. His striking is very, up to par as well, shall I say. It's not his strong suit. Now, Kyle, on the other hand, has very good jiu-jitsu as well.
He does have good. I mean, he's not belted jiu-jitsu, but he is a very solid grappler. I mean, he's won with heel hooks, he's won with submissions lots of times, so it's not like it's something that's out of his repertoire.
Sure.
But his stand-up game is where he's, in my opinion, that's where he's scary.
Well, and I would say that's where Thiago has been working on. He has been improving that stand-up game. You know, for him, he would much rather see it at the ground, on top specifically.
Right.
Kind of working his different positions. Woo! He loves the belly position. You see those leg kicks. I love to see leg kicks out of people.
Right. You know, what I'm liking is that as soon as Thiago landed, it was a nice leg kick, that Kyle just kind of took the momentum and spun around
yeah.
and then threw his own leg kick.
Uh-huh.
Just, okay, here's one
I
for
got
you.
One, too.
Yep.
You show me yours.
So, you know, these guys are, not surprisingly, very slow-paced and kind of meticulous in this first round. This is
a main event for a reason.
Well, and it's a pro title fight. This is five-minute rounds. And Thiago did the fake overhand right.
Yeah,
he did.
Well, you could tell he was trying to figure out a way to get in to get it to the ground.
Oh, and Kyle's got to be careful with those north-south elbows. He wasn't hit with the point of the elbow. You saw him just say that.
Uh-huh.
He was hitting with the back of the tricep.
Yes.
Which does become legal, but because it was up and down as far as the direction of the hand, that's why the referee mentioned something. Kyle looked like he was trying to stack up for the T-wrap on the arm in case that takedown was going to actually happen, and it looks like that happened just fine.
Well, it did, and you're going to see Thiago start to slowly climb, almost start to, what I consider almost eat that up, slowly but surely start eating pieces of legs up, and, trying to get to a higher position where that mount is more around the waist, shall I say. He's got those legs wrapped up a little bit,
yeah.
But nothing clean.
Yeah, I'm not going to say it's a bad idea that Kyle was focusing on the wrist so much, but at the same time, I would really like to see Kyle try and suck that right leg through and start pushing on that knee to get out of that position. But now he's going for a heel hook. Ooh. Nice. Thiago did a great job of getting out of there as soon as Kyle started lacing. You saw Thiago bounce out.
Well, and you saw Thiago's mount right now. He pinned that, what was it, left leg of Kyle down, got it right into this mount position. Kyle could be in some trouble from here.
Yeah, Kyle could definitely be in some trouble from here. But, Kyle is a strong guy. And like you said, he's got some ground game, too.
Oh, yeah,
so,
and it's early in the fight.
You know, I don't think that it's something that he needs to worry too much about. I expect someone like Thiago to really use this position as far as striking.
Uh-huh.
to set up an armbar attempt.
Agreed.
I don't see him really trying to win with it, but you see him right now. He's trapping the arm. The left leg's starting to come up. And
he started going for it a little too much. I think Kyle saw that.
He
was able to kind of.
He got the knee through, and there you go. So he's out of the mount, but at the same time, Tiago's still in a dominant position right now.
Well, and Tiago loves to use those knees. He loves to use the knees from these positions to either, you know, knee on belly, knee on arms to kind of separate them.
Americana.
Let's see if he can suck it in a little bit tighter.
Yeah, if he can bring it in closer to the body.
Yep.
And he's got a good angle on it, but Kyle's doing a great job of trying to straighten. There, that's going to finish it right there. Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is over. This fight's over, ladies and gentlemen, but Tiago is still holding grudges about yesterday with the weigh-ins and the disrespect.
I told you there was some fire, ladies and gentlemen.
There
was some fire.
Now, that was well after the tap, well after the referee stopped.
Well,
he came
after
in.
The tap.
He kicked him, and then he threw a punch at him. He's still going after him. There might be some repercussions as far as the athletic commission goes.
I think it's something to be watched. I mean, what I saw was, you know, Tiago was pulling. He ended up tapping. Kyle pushed him off. As Kyle pushed him off, said something. Tiago turned around, kicked him.
And then threw a punch at him afterwards.
Yeah.
I didn't see the Kyle say something. I was looking over at you, and then I saw the action happen.
Kyle said something and pushed him off of the top. And that's when Tiago turned around and kicked him.
Kicked him and then threw a punch. And,
you know
what? They're not calmed down yet either.
No,
so,
and that's why they're going to not be letting people in the cage as much.
What they need to do is get Kyle out of the cage, have the commission escort him out, and then let them announce the winner with just Tiago in the cage.
Agreed.
They need to get Kyle out of there, in my opinion. But I'm not the commission, so I don't make those rules. But I would be surprised if Tiago doesn't get some sort of punishment from the athletic commission.
Agreed. I mean, we did have the finish. What was that, the second round?
That was 3 minutes and 53 seconds into the
first round. Sorry.
And,
what happened in the cage was the second round.
Yeah, that we've been experiencing the second round this whole time, or the second fight. Immediate rematch?
Yeah. In the cage.
Wow.
All right, gang. Don't forget December 9th.
Yeah, you see Fabio. Hey, you can't really see it on the camera right now, but Fabio St. Hall is talking to Kyle and trying to calm him down and, you know, kind of get the point across to what's going on. I know it looks like Kyle doesn't know what the heck just happened.
Make sure you stand up.
So they're talking, being very amicable, which is a good thing. You see over here in the black corner, Tiago's, you know, bowing down and traditional, you know, apology. And they're being very respectful.
It looks like they're trying to figure it out here. You know, there is a language
barrier. Put your hands together. Make some noise for these two fighters working it out.
They're using gestures.
Adrenaline gets flowing. Blood gets flowing.
So very good job of both these guys. I mean, bad blood just got settled the best way it can.
Gentlemen,
I hate seeing the stuff that did happen after the bell or after the tap, but I do like seeing them clear the air.
3 minutes and 55 seconds in the round, number one. Then a tap out of the black corner. Tiago Alves!
All right, let's take it to the cage.
Everybody, please get home safely tonight. We want you to come back and play with us again December 9th at the Rail Event Center. Stay in touch. Steel Fist Fight Night on Facebook. Here's Matt for the NKH interview.
All right, I'm here with your winner, Tiago Alves. Tiago, you are the new Steel Fist Professional Lightweight Champion. How are you feeling right now, brother?
I mean, I feel great, man. Thank you so much for my Team League family, for my family in Brazil, my wife, and my kids, Enzo, Lucas, my wife, Nate. She knows how hard you work for the belt. I almost fought for the promotion 6 years. Now is my time. I apologize for everybody not see the show. You guys here for Kick the Guy. I'm sorry because I'm sorry. Apologize for you guys. Sorry.
Hey, man, we appreciate the apology. I know there was some sort of bad blood from last night and probably a misunderstanding over here at the end of the fight. We're not going to get into that too much. Is there anyone you want to thank for your win tonight?
Yeah. Thanks so much for my master, Fabio Serrão. He taking me everybody, every day, to train hard. He put all the work for me and all my teammates, the Rockwell, my coach Eric, my coach Alex, all the guys that need to help me, my brother Carlão, he's here to see me win. Thank you so much, guys. Okay, I apologize again for what happened tonight. Thanks so much.
Hey, we're just happy that you guys were able to shake hands and be good after everything. So it's no bad blood as far as we're concerned. We love having you out here. Are you going to come and defend the belt?
For sure. It's my badge now. It's terrible.